Need a stretch? No, no stretching? Okay. Here we go. Uh-oh, he's lacing them up. Lacing them up. How do you feel?
I feel good.
All right, we'll see you after.
Welcome to the house. How's everyone doing today? We'll see you after. We'll see after. Happy Easter. He is risen. He is risen indeed. This year's Easter is unlike any Easter I've ever experienced before. The way the year started, January the 26th, 2020, people all over the world got rocked by the news that Kobe Bryant, one of his daughters, and the other people on that helicopter had passed away in a tragic accident. And I was coming out of church service that morning, and a junior high schooler runs up to me and says, "Kobe Bryant died." And I'm like, "What? Stop trolling me or whatever. Get out of here." And he just kept coming at me with this. And I just had to check my phone. And then I got the news. Oh, man. I was in shock the rest of the day. I'm still kind of in shock now. And it's Easter. Since the day that he passed, I've been binge watching Kobe Bryant video after Kobe Bryant video on YouTube, as I'm sure a lot of other people have. Just in an attempt to try to make sense of all of this.
He was talking a lot of trash. You better back it up.
So, Kobe Bryant is to this kid on the basketball court who God is to us in life. A force of nature that commands respect. Kobe was a god among men. Jesus was God among men. Kobe held basketball camps for kids who wanted to be like him, who wanted to learn from him. Kobe could score at will against these kids.
Black Mamba, 1. White Mamba, 0.
White Mamba. He could dominate this kid on defense.
I see.
Oh. Still, this kid has heart.
Oh.
And eventually, the White Mamba scored.
Kobe. Let's see if he can score. Let's see if he can score. Uh-oh. Oh! He scored! He'll be telling that to the grandkids.
But Kobe was just messing with him.
Hey! We go, uh-oh. Little trick move there. Uh-oh, hey. Hey, mouse in the house. Mouse in the house.
We all knew Kobe wasn't gonna lose.
Uh-oh. Hey! Let's give it up, give it up. What a game. Good job.
And then something crazy happens.
Who's next?
After Kobe trashes this kid, while everybody's cheering, Kobe asks, "Who wants to get destroyed next?"
Me!
Oh! Right here! Three things to notice here. 1. Kobe destroys this kid. 2. Even after destroying this kid, everybody in that gym, including that kid, still trusts Kobe. 3. Everybody in that gym, including the kid who just got destroyed, is willing to defend themselves against Kobe in a game of basketball. This is how loving God works. Well, one of the ways. Job 13:15. Though he slay me, yet will I trust in him, but I will maintain my own ways against him. Job had this Kobe moment with God. God literally destroys him. He takes away everything from him except for his own life. His property, his family, everything that he's ever cherished in his life is gone. And yet, Job still trusts God. In the same way that all those kids in that gym still trust Kobe after all the destruction they just saw. Job had everything taken away from him, and still he said, "God, I trust you, but I would like to have a word with you." Job got wrecked, and he still wanted to be in the presence of God. These kids love Kobe so much that they're willing to get destroyed by him just so that they can be in his presence, so that they can learn from him and learn about him. On this Easter Sunday, can we say that we love Jesus in the same way?
Where's my Jesus jersey?
Can we say that we are willing to get destroyed by him, that we are willing to go through really, really difficult things, like this coronavirus, just so that we can be in the presence of God, to get a chance to glimpse who God is and what we can learn from him. If we don't chase Jesus like this, then we're only chasing a shadow of Jesus. If all we're doing is chasing the blessing, the feel-good emotions, the comfort of the gospel, then it will be a very cold experience. We will only understand a shadow of what the gospel really is. We will miss all the details, the depth, the warmth of love that God has for us. The same goes for these kids at this camp. If the only reason why they're there is to chase his wealth, his championships, his fame, they're going to walk away from that camp understanding only a shadow of who Kobe was. He wasn't just a basketball player. This man won an Oscar.
From the moment I started rolling my dad's tube socks and shooting imaginary game-winning shots in the Great Western Forum,
he had a book written explaining his approach to life.
Mamba Mentality, How I Play with Andy Bernstein.
He wrote children's books.
Wizenard series for kids.
He produced TV shows, podcasts, and he started the Mamba Sports Academy. So, what made Kobe live his life the way that he did?
You know, it's just, you just evolve. You know, I move away from the game, but I take the lessons that I learned from the game and transition it to something else. I mean, you know, like, you retire and you wake up in the morning and do what? Right? It's important to wake up and have a purpose.
Yeah. Living a life with purpose is the key to living a meaningful life. If you wake up every day with no purpose, it will only be a shadow of the life you could have lived. Not only did Kobe live his life with purpose, but he lived it the best way he knew how.
It's a simple theory or idea to live life by. If you're going to do something, do it to the best of your ability.
Colossians 3:23. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Living our lives thinking that God is watching us has to help us step up our game, right? Maybe we don't really think God is watching. Working as if working for the Lord, giving it your best, it's the Mamba mentality, baby!
At Mamba Sports Academy, we embrace the Mamba mentality. The Mamba mentality is constant curiosity, asking questions. How do I become better today than I was yesterday? That means bringing passion to the process. It means bringing the maximum effort required to be great.
As we reflect on the gift of Jesus this Easter, do we chase him? Do we have a curiosity that leads us to keep asking questions so that we can be in deep relationship with him? Do we give God our passion, our effort, so that we can give him our best? By learning more about Kobe, even after he's passed away, we are deepening our relationship with him. Is that weird? What a great thing to know in life that just because somebody is no longer physically with us, our relationship with that person can continue. And continuing to get to know somebody even after they're dead is not weird. It's biblical. John 16:7. But very truly I tell you, it is for your good I am going away. Unless I go away, the advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. Jesus knew he was going to die on the cross, but he promised to still be around to love and to guide people through the gift of the Holy Spirit, also referenced as advocate or counselor in scripture. Jesus was preparing his disciples to continue to be in relationship with him even after his physical body was gone. And just like with Kobe, our relationship with him continues beyond death. If you feel like you've learned something about Kobe today, and I hope that you did, then you've also learned an important Easter truth. Death is the end of a life, not a relationship. We need to understand this so that we can live lives that are meaningful, practically, and spiritually. By looking at the life of Kobe Bryant and the promise of Jesus, do you believe that relationships can continue after death? If you do, then you are just one step away from believing in resurrection that leads to eternity. This is the gift of Easter. This is the gift of Jesus. Only you can choose that for yourself. Thanks for the memories, Kobe. Talk to you soon, brother. Peace.
This has been absolutely beautiful, you guys. I can't believe it's come to an end. You guys will always be in my heart, and I sincerely, sincerely appreciate it. No words can describe how I feel about you guys. And thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you guys. And I love you guys. And to my family, my wife, Vanessa, our daughters, Natalia and Gianna, you know, thank you guys for all your sacrifice. You know, for all the hours I spent in the gym working and training. And Vanessa, you holding down the family the way that you have. I can't, there's no way that I could thank you enough for that. So, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. And what can I say? Mamba out.